this is 2 weeks of your chance as a writer to learn about yourself, to learn how to get to yourself, but learn how you write, learn how you create, learn what is important to you, your themes, your ideas, what you wrestle with.
It's actually pretty simple here. Writers write, and that's what you do.
No preface.
You just did a preface. Oh, no, you said
that was,
no preface.
That was the irony.
Three classes a day. Each class is about an hour and a half.
8:30, we meet in the classroom with coffee.
We're going to continue our discussion of stories, and I have two really good pieces for us to read.
Right before each class, we have a free write that we do to get ourselves focused.
Let's get like back into writing space. I know we just heard all of that, but let's do a quick free write, sort of a short one. To sort of dust off cobwebs, refocus, re-energize, and we'll go from there.
They give the prompts, they encourage the reading, encourage the writing, but then they get down with the students and do the work right along with them.
Well, and a very important part of our role that I think is a real strength of the program is that we write too.
I want them to feel like I'm writing with them, that I'm taking the same risks that they take. So that sort of shared vulnerability, one that we have together in the class, is really important to the community. And I think that it's what causes better writing to happen.
So I think it's nice for them to see us as writers with them.
Yeah.
And to start thinking of themselves. In a lot of my conferences and session, a lot of my students said, you know, this is the first time I've really thought of myself as a writer, not just a kid who likes to write sometimes.
I think it's up to us to just kind of empower them to to stay in the chair.
Yeah.
You know, keep doing it, keep at it, keep writing it.
All of that, the same doubts, those same mood swings that you feel, I feel, in writing, artistically and commercially, you never have it made. I don't, and you don't. So we're in it together. We have more in common than perhaps we realize.
Then I saw you going to town. Take us to town.
This, at last, was the end of muddy beds, the end of the opaque soups with corpulent oily bubbles.
The distance seems longer, and your face is blurry. But in my memory, there's a vivid image of you. Because forever is forever, and it's meant only that way.
You see, Peter and Wendy were Siamese twins, and they were hanging in the sky.
So that's a perfect example of you not being able to judge how good your own work is.
I love that.
I just want to say that. That's, yeah.
These workshops would be the death of me, or the life of me. I'm not exactly sure yet.
I mean, we make the joke that it's, you know, writing boot camp, but I mean, it's as grueling of a writing experience as you can have.
How much did I write this past 2 weeks?
I did about 20 pages of work, 24 pages so far.
Here.
This is not part of my...
You know, my journal, I'm on journal number 5 now, like spiral book, notebook number 5.
When you fill a notebook, you can drain the ink out of a pen in 2 weeks here, which is pretty impressive.
It's going okay. It's too complicated. I have to simplify it.
I'm editing this piece.
I see.
And it's frustrating.
I need to cut more. It's too long.
Traditionally, they're given this message that they're not ready for presentation. They're not ready for publication. You've got to go through years of this and that before you are actually ready for all that. And then here, we do the whole scope. The writing is important, but sharing has to happen.
And who here is reading tonight? Everybody who looks nicer than everybody else. All right.
I'm very excited. As a matter of fact, I've done speaking before, and it's something I've gotten comfortable with.
And now I get to actually speak, doing what I love, reading poetry and prose and all that good stuff.
And if somebody gives a really good reading, afterwards everybody goes up to them like they just, you know, made the jump shot that won the game. I mean, it's like, you're like, oh my God, that was so amazing. If you had that experience, or even if you saw somebody else have that experience, it just sort of elevates the whole practice of writing permanently.
It trains them for what is part of the writing life.
Hello, I'm Julia Miley, and I'm in Kristen's class. I'm from Maywood, Massachusetts, and I'm going to be reading two poems. This first one is called The Yay.
Follow the music of the great organ grinder, his monkey to shine as a sensible guide.
I found a city inside of a weeping elm tree, inhabited by bees. Bees flew in tiny flying machines with cogs and propellers.
And one by one, I met their gestures, and I met their eyes, recognizing several children by their fourth, fifth, and sixth climb through the line, motivated not so much by hunger, but by the profound revelation of abundance.
He lifted his immense body from a squat and prowled forward, beauty personified, towards her. Her heart sped up, eyes widening, fist clenched. She did the only thing she could think to do.
I feared a ringing shriek that would rise. If you fished through my purse and pulled out your eyes, then your fingertips, then your neck. I know you need no subtraction, but your mysterious speech slips into my pockets.
If you subtract the whole field of amaranth from the whole field of your vision, you will get the one who died, who crept into the clemency of mud and waits to clutch an evergreen.
But this whole campus, it's hard to explain, but this whole campus, this place, is very conducive to creation.
I will take home a bag full of new memories, the email addresses of friends from all over the country, a strange confidence I never knew I had and hope I never lose.
A notebook full of started stories, James Wright poetry book.
Ideas, a lot of beginnings.
Appreciation for simplicity, appreciation for beauty, Jules' amazing Mexico story, Jeff's hilarious Andy story, Ben's creepy milk story.
I don't think you would get the same experience and the same feel. You wouldn't get the same quality of work anywhere else but here.
They share the rough stuff, you know, they share the stuff that might not be perfect, but they get the feedback from their peers to find out what sort of the heart of the piece is, or what the little nuggets of real brilliance are in the piece. And I think that's a really interesting and really rare thing. I don't think there's any other place where that happens.
Because people are trying more. They're out of their safe zone. They're taking a risk. They're writing something that they might not have dreamt of writing before they came. And that in some ways that is the best gift that we can give them, that the program can give them. To write often and to write variedly.
You can find yourself artistically, you can find yourself spiritually, mentally, but you have to be open. None of this works if you're not open to what can become you as a writer. And it's fun. It's a good place to be.
I'll take all of your smiles and ride on them through the rest of the summer and the rest of the year, and maybe I'll make it. I think I should leave my shoes here, because I don't want to be grounded anymore. I want to join the clouds and create a fairy tale of my own.
I saw it.